رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا وحبيبنا وشفيعنا وقرة أعيننا محمد الأمين نبي الأنبياء وخاتم المرسلين، وعلى آله وصحابته والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. إخواني وأخواتي، أكررها عليكم المرة بعد المرة، من أدعية الصالحين: اللهم لا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا، ولا تسلط علينا من لا يرحمنا. اللهم لا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا. اللهم لا تجعل الدنيا ترجم قوي ترجمتك. اللهم لا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا.
In the name of Allah, the Most Gracious, the Most Merciful, the All Merciful, the Especially Merciful. All praise is due to Allah, the Lord of the worlds. May His peace, blessings, mercy, honor, elevation, and protection be upon our Master, the Prophet of the Prophets, and the last of the messengers, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and his noble family, companions, and followers until the Day of Judgment. Glory be to you, O Allah, and far from imperfection are you. We have no knowledge except that which you have taught us. Indeed, you are the all-knowing and the all-wise. I've repeated to you many times that this dua of O Allah, do not make this Allahumma la taj'al dunya akbara hammina, the greatest of our worries, the greatest of our concerns. Do not make this world the greatest of our concerns, nor the extent of our knowledge. Do not make this world the
mablagha ilmina akbara hammina wala mablagha ilmina,
the greatest of our concerns nor the extent of our knowledge.
اسمعوا معنا الحديث: اللهم لا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا.
This is a narrated dua that is taught to us. O Allah, do not make this world the greatest of our worries, the greatest of our concerns, meaning, and the nor the extent of our knowledge.
اللهم لا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا ولا تسلط علينا من لا يرحمنا.
O Allah, do not make this world the greatest of our concerns, the extent of our knowledge, and do not send upon us as a punishment those who do not fear you, do not fear you in us.
عندما تسمعون
or
هذا
those
الدعاء
who do not have mercy on us.
عندما تسمعون هذا الدعاء فكيف تتعاملون معه.
Once you hear this dua, how do you react to it?
كيف تتعاملون معه؟
How do you deal with it?
اللهم لا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا.
The first part, for the world not to be the greatest of our concerns.
أولا لا تجعل في قلوبنا حتى نهتم بها.
Don't even put this world in our minds and our hearts so that we do not become concerned with it even.
ولا تجعل مبلغ علمنا أولا.
And do not make it the extent of our knowledge anyways.
أتعلمون معنى الدعاء؟ تحذير لنا، تحذير لا تجعل أصلا في عقولنا حتى نهتم بها.
So this dua that we are taught, this dua is in fact a warning.
حتى يكون الإنسان يدعو حتى لا يخطر بقلبه الانهماك في الدنيا.
That forget about just simply striving. Now we're asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us in this struggle of removing this dunya from our hearts, so that a person is even saying,
لا تجعل ابتداء. لا تجعل ابتداء.
Not in the first place, don't make this world the greatest of our concerns.
ولا مبلغ علمنا. لا تجعلها هي علمنا ابتداء.
That we don't even want to be attached to this world. We don't want to make this world the extent of our knowledge.
ما الفرق بيننا وبين معنى الدعاء؟
So this is something not only we strive for, And we make dua for, but what is the reality of our actions in relation to this dua?
نحن أكثر كامل.
We're working towards the opposite completely.
الهم الليل والنهار من العائلة ترتيب للحصول على هدف حقير من الدنيا.
Our worries day and night for
للعائلة
the family,
كلها.
For the entire
أب
family.
وأم وأولاد وزوار.
The father, the mother, the children, the guests is that world.
نرتب أن نجعل الدنيا هي همنا ليست أكبر هي همنا ليست أكبر
We're not just striving for this world, but we're striving to make this world our greatest concern.
لا شيء ليست أكبر
Our only concern.
فقط.
Forget about the greatest concern, our only concern.
وما قال لا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا.
And the dua is not even our only concern, our greatest concern.
ولا مبلغ علمنا نحن نخطط أن تكون الدنيا هي فقط علمنا لا شيء آخر معها.
And do not make this world the extent of our knowledge, but the only knowledge that we seek is exclusively worldly knowledge.
ولذلك لا تقبلون لبناتكم غير دكتور ولا مهندس.
The only knowledge we exclusively seek properly is worldly knowledge. To the point, and it's the only knowledge we value. That's why people only accept for their daughter to marry somebody with a degree like a doctor or an engineer, and for their sons even. Even for a man, they're looking for a wife for him. His parents are looking for a wife who's a doctor.
والله ما أبلدك رجل. والله الذي لا إله إلا هو. ولو تزوجت امرأة للدكتورة أو لشهادة لابني لتركته رفضا كاملا كاملا ما سلمت عليه طيلة حياتي.
I swear by Allah, what a foolish man you are if you are marrying somebody for their degree.
خصوصا الرجل.
Especially a man who's marrying someone for نعم a man who's marrying someone for his degree. If my son was to marry a woman for her degree, then I wouldn't speak to him for the rest of his life.
إلى أن يموت. أنت بليد. تتزوج ورقة.
Are you this foolish to marry a paper?
أنت بليد. أنت غبي تريد تكمل نفسك مرأة بليد.
You're a fool who wants to.
ترجم لا تستحي.
Complete yourself with a woman.
تريد تكمل نفسك بمرأة عندها شهادة.
With a woman's paper, with a woman's.
أنت
degree.
رجل قوام. الله تعالى يقول الرجال قوامون على النساء.
You're supposed to be a man who is responsible. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that men are guardians over women, caretakers.
وقد تكون أقبح من قرد. والله أنا رأيت.
Forget about taking care of your. It could be أعوذ بالله.
بمناسب شهادة أقبح من قرد. You know that. لشهادتها فقط. أنا رأيت بعيني. مرأة ما عندها جمال حتى فقط لشهادتها.
And she could be uglier than a monkey.
أنت تعرف هذا.
And you know this, but as
أنت أنت تخرج أنت تخرج من ديفيس. أنت تخرج من ديفيس تعرف
هذا. That value. You know this. You have graduated.
أنت عملك تعرف أصحابك.
From Davis, this is your business. This you know your friends.
أنتم لست أنتم هذا هو اللي كرهني في أعرابكم.
This is what made me hate your.
كل يوم تطلع على أعراب.
Your cultural norms.
My wife doctor. I hate your wife and you. Go. My wife, you don't know my wife? My doctor. أنت صغير أنت طفل. هذه أمك وزوجتك.
Alright, people value this worldly knowledge so much that they will say, they will be bragging, my wife, you know, as a doctor. Is this your wife or your mother? What are you bragging about? What did you accomplish?
You know, it's my wife, doctor. I hate to hear that. أنا عندما أسمع رجل يقول هذه زوجتي أو أنا أقول هذا بليد أصلا.
When I hear a man bragging about his wife's accomplishments in front of men, this is that's enough to discredit him.
ها أقول أنت لست عاقل ها ليس لا يمكن الرجل لا يتكلم أمام الناس بهذا.
What kind of man does this anyways?
ها ليس يقول الإفهام شيء هذا ليس كلام الرجال الرجال يحتاج أن يكونوا رجال.
This is not fitting for a
أنا
man.
أنا مشكلتي مع الرجال ليس مع النساء النساء مساكين مغرومات.
My problem is with the men, the women, they're being oppressed.
ما عندهم رجال يعني.
There are no men for them to depend on.
ولا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا ولا تسلط علينا من لا يرحم. لذلك في الحديث الصحيح من ابتلي من البنات بشيء، من ابتلي من البنات أو الأخوات، الرجل مسؤول. لا بد أن تفهموا أن الرجل مسؤول.
You have to understand the responsibility of being a man. That in the hadith it is even mentioned, whoever is attested with that responsibility, meaning of having daughters or sisters.
Yeah.
You have to understand this responsibility that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has equipped you for.
أنت الله جعلك رجلا، رجل رجل، قالك أنت مسؤول. من ابتلي من البنات أو الأخوات بشيء فأحسن إلينا كنا له سترا من النار.
Whoever is tested with daughters or sisters at all and he fulfilled, he took care of them, then they
كنا له سترا من النار.
A barrier from him entering the fire.
أنت رجل، أنت مسؤول، يعني أنت مسؤول، يعني تفكر، افتح عينيك، يعني انظر الى الفوق، يعني لا
So you have to understand if you're a man you're responsible. You have to look towards this responsibility.
الرجولية مهمة جدا، يعني هذا هو اللي أفسد العالم الإسلامي. نحن ما عندنا
You have to take care of this responsibility. This is, and abandoning it is what has corrupted the Muslim world.
أنا أعرف رجل شيخ يسمى شيخ في هنا في أمريكا، هو الآن سيطلق زوجته. لماذا؟ ما هو السبب؟ هو يقال شيخ يدرس
في المعهد. There's a man who is a teacher and he's called a sheikh here in America and he's about to divorce his wife for what reason?
يقول أنت تستخدمين، أنت لا تشتغلين.
He says you're just using me. You don't, you're not working. You're just letting me work and take care of you. This is not.
نقاش، هذا نزاع الآن، يعني نزاع. أنت يعني تنامين، يقول أنت تنامين، تجلسي في البيت، أنت تنامين.
There's a conflict between him and her. He says, "You're just sleeping at home and staying at home and letting me work. And she has three kids. And one of them is handicapped. He says, "Why are you taking advantage of me, and you're not going and working?" This is the American mentality.
هذه عقلية غريبة جدا. هي ما كفى، هي ما كفى هذا من العذاب عنده ثلاثة أولاد واحد معتل.
It's not enough of a struggle for her to have three children and one of them to be handicapped.
يا ما كفى هذا، يعدها نائمة.
And he's accounting her as, oh, you're just sleeping at home all the time.
تستخدمينني.
And taking advantage of me.
وهذا عادي، هذا والآخر يقول هذا صحيح، لا لا بد.
And everybody is nodding their heads along with him,
you know. You know, it's America, 50-50. 50-50. 50-50. هل هي 50-50 عندكم؟
Right, this is your American 50-50.
طيب. 80-50. رجل أستاذ، يعني سيطلق زوجته بسبب أنها ما تعمل.
There's a person who's a teacher and a ustadh and he's divorcing.
يحسب نفسه مظلوما.
And he's thinking she's oppressing him because she's not working.
استغفر الله، هاي حياة سيئة جدا.
This is, what a terrible lifestyle.
ليست حياة، هاي ليست زواج ولا شيء.
This is not life and this is not a marriage.
It's stupid marriage. I hate his marriage.
رجل بليد أكرهه وأكره زواجكم.
أنا أشهدكم أني أكره الزواج في أمريكا. I hate marriage. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. عبد الإله الشنقطي يشتري بعقده المنظوم تبر الأخضر فرب من عرض اضطرار الحسنة لعلني أنال الأجر والزنة. الحمد لله رب العالمين، ثم الصلاة والسلام للأمين سيدنا محمد إمام رسولنا والأنبياء الختام. أول واجب على من كلف تصحيحه إيمانه ويعرف مصلح فرض العين كالإحكام للطهر والصلاة والصيام، وواجب حفظ حدود الحي بالوقف عند أمره والنهي، وأن يتوب قبل سخط الله سبحانه عليه بالملاهي، وشرطها الندم، والنية أن يكف والإقلاع عن غير الحسن، ولا يؤخر ويقول حتى تعن هداية الله له، فذاك من علامة الشقاء والخذلان وطرس قلبه عن الإيمان. والحفظ للبصر عن صريح، والحفظ للسان عن صريح فحش وكل كلم قبيح، وأيمن الطلاق وانتهار مسلم أو إذلاله بعار أو إهانه بعار، بعار من سب أو تخويفه لمنع جميعها بغير حق شرعي. والحفظ للسان عن صريح عن حرام، والحفظ للبصر عن حرام كنظرة تضيء أخ الإسلام، حيث كان فاسقا لن يزجرا، فواجب دون أذى أن يهجرا، وحفظه ما استطاع للجوارح، وأن يحب لله الفاتح، والبغض والرضا له، ويأمرا بالعرف ثم النهي عن منكرا، وتحرم الغيبة ثم الكذب، نميمة كبر الرياء عجب، وسمعة وحسد، والبغض مع رؤيته الفضل على الغير امتنع، همز ولمز عبث سخرية، زينا وأن ينظر أجنبية، ولذة بصوتها والأكل بغير طيب النفس لا يحل، وبالشفاعة أو الدين أو أن يؤخر الصلاة عن وقت الحسن، ولم تجد صحبة فاسق يا لطيف، ولم تجد صحبة فاسق ولا جلاسه دون ضرورة الولاء، ولا رضا الخلق بسخط الخالق، فالله أولى بالرضا من فاسق، وقال لا طاعة للمخلوق في معصية الخالق خير من قفي، ولا يحل الفعل حتى يعلم حكم الإله بسؤال العلماء، ويقتدي بالعلماء العاملين التابعين سنة خير المرسلين، لولا يدلنا على الرحمن محذرين طرق الشيطان، أو يحذرون طرق الشيطان، لا ترضى ما رضيه المفلس من ضاع عمره بعصيان والسوء، يا حسرة العصاة في القيامة ما أطول البكاء والندامة، نسأله سبحانه توفيقنا لسنة الهادي وختم الحسن. قال الإمام الأخضري، الإمام الأخضري أصله رجل ببلاد الجزائر، وإمام كبير في العلم، وله مؤلفات كثيرة في العلم، منها عقود الجمال في البيان، ومنها السلم في المنطق، وقدم هذه المقدمة رحمة بالضعاف من المسلمين، مقدمة نثرية أولها أخلاق، وهي هذه المقدمة التي قرأناها، وبعد ذلك مقدمة في الفقه من الطهارة والصلاة. هذه المقدمة نافعة جدا، صاحبها جزائري الأصل، ومتوفى سنة 983 في الهجرة، ولقد نظمها أحد أعلام العلماء الموريتانيين، ويقال له عبد الله بن الحاج حماه الله، منسوب إلى أبي بكر الصديق رضي الله تعالى عنه، ومن مشاهير علماء ذلك البلد، ومقدمة نافعة جدا، وشهدت بركتها في البلاد كلها من لدن ما يقارب 500 عام.
This is the poem form of Al-Akhdari, the
الأخضري بنفسه عبد
known,
الرحمن الأخضري.
Which is named after عبد الرحمن الأخضري. This is the poem form of that basic text in fiqh of purification and prayer that was authored by Abd al-Rahman al-Akhdari, an Algerian scholar, a very great scholar, a very, very great scholar. And subhanAllah, the book of his that is the most known is this, that covers the most basic of knowledge. He begins with knowledge in regard to a character, in regard to correcting oneself, self-purification. Then he enters into a purification and prayer, a physical purification and prayer. And he passed away about the year 983 after Hijrah, about 500 years ago, almost 500 years ago he passed away. And he was in Algeria. And this book that he has written, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has spread the benefit of it across the lands.
وهذا
And
الرجل عالم.
The person who wrote this poem form is called Abdullah ibn al-Hajj. Much more recently, he turned it into a poem form, so it's much easier for students to memorize. The Mauritanian.
بكريون.
Abdullah ibn al-Hajj. And he's the descendant of Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu.
عبد الإله الشنقيطي يقول المؤلف الناظم عبد الإله عبد الله الشنقيطي، معناها الموريتاني، موريتانيا ما دامت تسمى الشنقيطة كانت أرض علم، والآن صارت أرض فرنسية وقال موريتاني، لابد أن تفرق بين الشنقيط وبين موريتانيا.
So he begins, he says عبد الإله الشنقيطي, then which is عبد الإله meaning Abdullah, referring to himself. الشنقيطي, this is from the land of الشنقيط, which is the name of the land itself. As for now, unfortunately, when it was Arab, as for now, unfortunately, it became French and is known as Mauritania. But it's actually, the name of it is الشنقيط.
الاسم الصحيح لا يناسب شنقيط.
The correct, a more appropriate title for the land is الشنقيط and not Mauritania.
يعني يضمم هذا الأبان يقول فالحمد لله مرب العالمين، لا تحتاج إلى غيره.
نعم.
الحمد لله مرب العالمين من أهل القائم بمصالح العالمين.
That he authors this text, and then he says, "Alhamdulillah." So all praise is due to Allah, the nurturer of the of all creation.
ثم الحمد لله رب العالمين ثم الصلاة والسلام للأمين النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Then he says, "Alhamdulillah." So he says, "Alhamdulillah," the nurturer of all creatures. Then the salawat and salam for the trustworthy one, sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
صلى الله عليه وسلم. سيدنا محمد إمام رسول الله سيد الخلق.
Our master Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the Imam of the Messengers.
والأنبياء الختام إمامهم وخاتمهم.
And the Imam of the Messengers and Prophets and their seal.
أول واجب على من كلف تصحيحه إمامه. أول واجب على المكلف. أول واجب
says
اسمعوا.
The first obligation upon the responsible person is what?
تصحيح عقيدته.
To correct his faith, to learn his proper beliefs, to correct his improper beliefs into the proper beliefs.
ماذا قال المؤلف؟ أول واجب على المكلف تصحيح إيمانه، عقيدة صحيحة.
So the first obligation upon the responsible person is to have correct عقيدة.
ما هو أول واجب المكلف عندنا هنا الآن؟
But what do we consider the first obligation upon the responsible person?
ما هو الواجب عندنا الآن أول واجب على المكلف؟ هاي سكول؟ هذا طبعاً
right,
بلا شك
to finish high
بلا
school.
شك
For a person to now become an adult and to be mature and to be responsible,
تعرفون الآن الأطفال يبلغون في أمريكا غالباً 12 13 like that هذا معروف
You know most children are reaching puberty around 12 13 years old
هذه أيام هاي سكول هاي أيام فساد العقيدة
And then after that, they enter into high school and corrupt their beliefs.
هذا تصحيح إيمانه فساد عقيدته بالعكس. أول واجب على المكلف من الوالدين ونفسه أن يفسد عقيدته هنا.
So now, as a person reaches adulthood and their adolescence, they are doing what? They're corrupting their beliefs.
كان على الفطرة والآن سيتغير عقيدته.
Before that, they were on the pure natural belief, and now their belief is going to be corrupted.
كان يمهد له لتزول الفطرة والآن دخل المشاكل.
In
من
the
خمس
previous
سنين
years,
يمهد له.
The building the way was being paved for his nature to be corrupted.
إلى ما يبلغ 12 يبدأ.
Now once he's 12 years old, that's it.
هذا الشاب الأمامي الآن هذا الرجل قال لي الهاي سكول هي مركز الزنا هذا الشاب.
This young man in
وأنت
front of me.
وهذا.
نعم هذا معلوم.
هذا معلوم من نعم. أنت قلت هذا معلوم من الدين طبعا. Okay, thank you.
that this young man in front of me and
everybody tell me
nobody this is the other word for high school this is a place where people begin their zina if not before
thank you أول واجب على المكلف تصحيح العقيدة القرب من الله تعالى أول واجب على المكلف والدفع من الوالدين يجعله في هاي سكول
Now, when a person is gaining, becoming responsible, this is why puberty was mentioned. Because once you reach puberty, Islamically, you're responsible.
تعلق برب العالمين تصحيح عقيدة حتى تكون تعلم من هو الرب.
That a person who reaches that age, they should have their correct aqidah known and memorized, and it's required of them, not they.
أما قبل ذلك فالأفضل للآباء أن يعلموهم. ما فرض الله عليهم قبل البلوغ ليتعودوا كما قال ابن أبي زيد القرواني المغربي.
But before that they should already have been prepared as Ibn
Abi
Zayd al-Qarawani said their parents should have prepared them and taught them this information and allowed them
ليبلغ الطفل وقد تعود.
So once they reach puberty they've already gotten used to fulfilling the obligations and wearing what they wear and doing what they do and praying and so on.
الطفل مسكين قاعد ماذا يفعل الطفل هو أبوه يوم 50 سنين قال له أنت ستبدأ المدرسة النظامية.
But then now, unfortunately, what people are doing as soon as, without question, without fail, once they're 5 years old, okay, you're going to start public school.
وكان عنده بوك فيها A B C D. عنده كرتون.
And he already is watching cartoons and reading books that have A B C D.
من اشترى لك هذا؟
Who bought you this?
My mom. أمي والزوج هو اللي يدفع. والدين كانوا يجهزوا من لدن سنته الأولى آيفون وأي بي سي كارتون كله إنجليزي وأفكار غربية تلفاز.
The parents were setting him up for when he was far younger to learn. Okay, here are your ABCs and here are your cartoons.
سنتين
and here's
أين سنتين؟ أنت عمرك سنتين؟
Oh, you're 2 years old.
نعم. أعرف فتح التلفون وأعرف كل شيء.
2 years old, knowing how to open a phone, unlock a phone, you know, get through any password.
ما أحتاج ما أحتاج له.
Already hacking.
هذا صحيح؟
نعم.
طيب شكرا. كلكم راع وكلكم مسؤول عن رعيته. لا بد أن نفهمه.
We have to understand. شكرا. All of you are shepherds.
شكرا.
And each one of you is responsible. كلهم
شكرا.
Thank you very much.
كلكم راع خطاب ممن؟
This is an this is who is saying this, that all of you are responsible, the Prophet
كلكم راعي.
All of you, each one of you is a shepherd.
وكلكم مسؤول عن رعيتي.
And each one of you is responsible for their flock.
الأمير طبعا راعي. عمر بن الخطاب مسؤول عن الرعية.
The Amir, the leader, the like Umar bin al-Khattab, for example, of course, is a shepherd. He has a huge flock. He knows that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he takes into account that Allah will hold him accountable not just for the people who he is the leader of, but for the animals that they're taking care of. He said that if a sheep broke her leg, if a ewe broke her leg by the Euphrates river all the way in Iraq, I would be asked about it. Umar ibn al-Khattab would be asked about it in the Day of Judgment.
والرجل من أيوة تبع تفضل بعد الأمير.
So then yes, the leader of course is irresponsible.
أمير البيت.
And
بعد
then after
that, الإمارة العامة.
That first the general leader, meaning the political leader, then the leader of the household, the man is a shepherd and he is responsible for his flock.
الرجل راعي.
The man is a shepherd and I seek Allah's refuge.
استغفر الله
and I seek
من
Allah's
الرجل.
Forgiveness for the men today.
الرجل راعي عمن هو مسؤول.
The man is responsible and he's a shepherd over those he is responsible over.
زوجته وأولاده.
Who is he responsible for? His wife and his children.
ما هي المسؤولية؟
What is his responsibility?
يقصها رب العالمين.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us what that responsibility is.
قو أنفسكم وأهليكم نارا.
Save yourselves and your families from a fire.
قو أنفسكم وأهليكم نارا. ما هو معناها؟
What does it mean to save yourselves and
تعلم
your families from
يجب
a fire?
عليك.
I mean you have to learn.
علم الزوجة والأولاد.
Teach your wife and children.
حتى حكم الحيض واجب عليك إجماعا أن تعلمه لزوجتك والأولاد.
Even by consensus.
إجماعا.
Obligatory for you to teach the rulings of menstruation to your wife and children, to your wife and daughters.
لكن ما هي حالنا؟
But what is our state in contrast to that?
عندما يدخل وقت الزواج شروط البيت غرفة المدرسة.
When it's time for marriage, what do we consider obligations? A job and a house and a degree.
ما هو عملك؟
What do you do?
ما هو عملك؟ ما هي عملك؟
What do you do? What's your work? What do you work? Where do you work?
طيب. We mix our money. سنخلط مالنا وسنكون شركة في البيت. هذا هو الطبيعي.
That okay. Let's. We're both gonna work for a few years. We'll put our money together and get a house.
أنا هو راعي وهي هو مرعي. أنا
لا. So that means is he
أين الراعي؟ أين الراعي وأين المرعي؟
Is he a shepherd or is he a sheep? Where is the shepherd and who is where is the flock?
لا أحد.
No one.
شرك.
It's a partnership.
هذا صحيح؟
نعم.
شركة لا توجد في الإسلام.
This partnership is not a part of Islam.
لا يوجد في الإسلام. لا توجد شركة في الإسلام. راعٍ مرعيٌ خلاص.
You can't have a shepherd who's a part of the flock.
لا توجد شركة في الإسلام أصلاً. لا. لا أصلا لا توجد مطلقا. الشركة لا توجد بالإسلام أصلا، لا أصل لها ولا فرع.
This partnership, there is no foundation for it or root of it or branches of it in
راعٍ
Islam.
مرعيٌ، راعٍ مرعيٌ.
A shepherd who is a part of his own
الراعي
flock.
الرجل.
The shepherd is the man.
المرعية المرأة والأولاد.
And the flock is his wife and children.
طيب خلاص. هو مسؤول عن كل شيء حقير ونقير، تعليم، بيت، طعام، شراب، كل شيء.
He is responsible for everything. He is responsible for the household, for the house, for the
وقبل
shelter.
التعليم، قبل ذلك كله التعليم.
Before all of that is the teaching.
قوة أنفسكم ورجالا، ليس ابنوا لهم بيتا.
For teaching, for providing teaching and food and and cover and shelter and so on. But the first of those responsibilities is to provide for them their Islamic education. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, save yourselves and your families from a fire. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't say save them from the rain
ما
and shelter.
قال ابن بيتا ولا حصل
Build
الطعام.
A house or provide food
لا.
First. No, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said
إن
save
كان
them from
عندك.
A fire.
إن كان عندك مسؤول عنك. إن كان عندك.
If you are able to provide those things, then you're obligated to provide them.
ولذلك نص العلماء على أن المرأة إذا تزوجت بفقير لا تسقط نفقتها عن أبيها.
And this is why the scholars mentioned that if a man marries his daughter to a poor person, if a woman marries a poor man, then her father
تبقى
remains
نفقتها على أبيها.
Her father
مسؤوليتها
remains
تبقى على أبيها.
Responsible to spend upon her.
لأنها مسؤول عنها حيثما كانت.
Because he is responsible for her wherever she goes.
هي مسؤول عنها المرأة في الشريعة مسؤول عنها أينما كانت إما زوج وإما أب وإما ابن.
Because the woman has to have somebody responsible for her wherever she goes, however, whatever state she's
أبون
in.
أو زوج أو ابنون.
Regardless, is it her husband? Is it her child? Is it her son? Or is it her father? Somebody has to be.
هذا لا بد من واحد من أحد أمرين. أو تكون ذلك بعد ذلك شيء لا راد لقضاء لا أب لها ولا زوج لها ولا أبناء هذا شيء آخر.
And then, but then, if she has no father, and no son, and no brother, you know, then this is a, then this is, you know, the Allah سبحانه وتعالى's decree for some people, and that's a different matter.
فهمتم هذه الشريعة لا بد أن نفهم الشريعة.
But
راعي
this is the Sharia.
مرعي.
The shepherd and the flock.
لا يخدعكم المحاضر هاي الشريعة.
Don't be deceived by the speakers today. This is the Sharia.
الشركة لا توجد.
The partnership you're thinking about, it doesn't exist.
لا يخدعكم لا يظلمونكم. هذا ظلم.
Don't let them deceive you and oppress you.
لا كل يأخذ مسؤوليته كل يأخذ مسؤوليته فقط كل يأخذ. المرأة مسؤول عنها مسؤولة راعية. راعية للأولاد راعية للبيت راعية للزوج تطيعه وتستمع أوامره لا في معصيته وخلاص المرأة راعية
The woman, she's a shepherd also.
ما هي مسؤوليتها
But what is her flock? What is her responsibility?
أولادها حضانتهم البيت السمع والطاعة للزوج خلاص
Her children, her household, maintaining it, listening to her husband, that's it.
إلا في معصيته
Listening to him except in that which is a disobedience to Allah.
لكن بالعكس الآن.
But unfortunately, it seems to be the opposite today.
هي لا تستمع له في أي شيء إلا في معصيته.
She doesn't listen to him in anything unless he's inviting her to sinfulness.
إذا دعاها لمعصية فسمع وطاعة.
If he calls her to something sinful, then yes, we hear and we obey.
إذا قالها جلس في البيت لا مستحيل.
If he tells her stay at home, nope.
لا مستحيل لماذا تقول لي هذا
why are you telling me this
لا تدرس في الجامعة لا مستحيل
don't go to college no why you can't stop me
هذا صحيح
is this true
هذا صحيح لكن إذا قال لها تعالي وامشي معي إلى أصدقائي وكن معنا في الجامعة ولا تلبس الحجاب ولا تفعلي وكون فاسقة أفسق من نمرود تقول له طبعا هذا هو الذي لا خلاف فيه أصلا
But if he tells her, okay, let's go. Go to a mixed college. You know, come hang out with me and my friends. Let's go, you know, wear your makeup and don't wear your hijab and become more, you know. She'll say, okay.
هذا ما كنا نبغي.
This is what we were trying to
هذا
get.
هو اللي توافقنا عليه وزواجنا
This is what we were after the whole time anyways for the, our
marriage.
This is what our, the purpose of our
marriage is.
This is why we got married anyways.
هذا صحيح أم لا؟
نعم, is this true or not? This is true.
طيب. معناها ما عندكم زواج أصلا.
That means you don't have marriage anyways in the first place.
أنا قلت لكم مليار مرة ما رأيتكم تزوجتم.
I told you a billion times I don't see that you're even married.
أنتم ما تزوجتم؟ يا رجال ما تزوجتم ويا نساء ما تزوجتم؟
What you have is not marriage. Oh men, you're not married.
ما تزوجتم أصلا؟
You never got married. You haven't seen what marriage is.
ما تزوجتم أصلا؟ وجد الأولاد ووجدت الجنسية المجانسة ولكن الزواج ما وجد.
You may have had children, you may have a physical relationship, but the true marriage is not, is non-existent. I have not seen it with my eyes.
أصلاً. أصلاً.
In the, anyways, in the first place.
لأن الزوجية معناً. ولذلك الله تعالى يقول وجعل بينكم مودة ورحمة. أين المودة وأين الرحمة عندكم؟
The marriage that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions as a miracle in the Quran is Allah says that He placed in it love and mercy. Where is your love and mercy?
هذا الرجل أمامي. أنت تعرف فيه مرأة قلت لها قبل وهي بنتها أمامك ماذا قالت لك اثنتين إحداهما كبيرة في السن 50 سنة والأخرى بنتها صغيرة قال قلت لها استريحي لا تشتغلي لأولادك أحفادك قالت لا أنا عندي نشاط كثير حتى لأحفادي ولكن زوجي نتي لا شيء.
What words did she use?
Exactly.
Wow.
هو هذا حاضر.
That she said that there was a mother here. And her daughter is also a mother. The grandmother is in her 50s. And she's
مريضة
running.
مريضة عندك من عملية تكاد تموت.
And she's running back and forth and she's saying and he told her the brother here he said sit down don't worry we'll take care of it don't trouble yourself and she said no I have a lot of energy for my grandchildren but for my kids but for my husband
nothing. I don't want to do anything.
I won't do anything for him. And then her daughter who was sitting right there.
Yes, she said me too.
She said me too. Yeah. No, that's the same thing.
شكرا.
قالت وأنا أيضا.
أنا أيضا كذلك. أنا على ملة أمي. أنا على طريقة أمي.
I'm on the same way as my mother. Forget about my husband. I only have energy for my kids.
وبعد ذلك الأبناء سيطلعون هكذا.
And of course, this is gets passed on.
لأن هي اللي طلعت البنت هكذا.
Because she's the one who, I mean, she's the one who made her daughter this way. Tell me, where is the mercy in this? And where is the love in this? This is a calamity, this is not a marriage.
تتحدى زوجها تقول ما عندي لك شيء هذا أنا سأكون أخدم أبنائي هكذا أنا أملي أنا خادم أنا I'm slave for my kids but you nothing.
A woman that disrespects her husband like this, saying I'm a slave for my kids but you're nobody.
ستة. Until I tell you come to sleep next to me. He's happy. You know that. اجلس هناك حتى أخبرك بأن تجلس تنام بهم. هذه الحياة.
This is your life.
لذلك كل يوم طلاق وكل يوم مشاكل وكل يوم وما في أولاد وما في عائلة مشاكل أحزان وأوهام. ترجم.
This is why there's divorce. All the time, and there's no proper family structure.
لا أولاد
and you just
ولا.
Have, and even the children are victims of this.
لا أولاد يرون النار, النار تسعر أمامهم. يرون النار تسعر أمامهم.
The norm is just anxiety and depression with everybody.
يرون أباهم في النار.
The children just see their parents in a battleground and fighting each other all the time.
نعم. أول واجب على من كلها تصحيح إيمانه ويعرف مصلحة فرض العين أول واجب على المكلف أن يصحح عقيدته ويصلح فرض عينه. هذا الواجب على المكلف، تصحيح إيمانه ومعرفة أحكام الطهارة وصلاته. يا إخواني يا مسلمون، اعلموا أن الهاي سكول ليست واجبة، والكارز ليست واجبة، والمدرسة النظامية ليست واجبة، حتى تكونوا، حتى أقابلكم أمام رب العالمين وأنا خال من الذم من 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 العهدة بيني وبينكم.
So he says the first obligation upon the responsible person is to correct his faith, meaning to learn his proper aqidah, and then to know firmly the rules of fiqh, of his fard ayn, such as purification, prayer, and fasting, and charity. So I will tell you something very clearly, so that I'm not held responsible in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for deceiving you or coming short. I'll tell you without mincing words, middle school, high school, elementary school, college, they are not obligatory. They are not some. Get it out of your heads that this is something that your children need. This is not something that you will be asked about at all in regard to them. Did you provide for them this education?
وما تآباؤكم وأحفاد وأحفادكم وما دخلوا مدرسة نظامية كنتم عند أمام الله من أسعد السعداء.
If you passed away and you faced Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala while your children had never been to public school, and your children and grandchildren and great-great-great-grandchildren never stepped foot in a public school or elementary school or high school,
وقابلتم رب العزة,
and you were to face Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with this,
لكنتم أسعد الناس وأقربهم إليه إذا طبقتم شرع الله.
Forget about being in trouble. You would be from the happiest of people if you had implemented the command.
إذا علمتهم الطهارة والصلاة وحفظتهم شيئا من كتاب الله.
If you had just even simply taught them purification and prayer and a little bit of the Quran.
فسيقول لكم رب العالمين أحسنتم الرعاية.
And you would be awarded by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala a reward for treating them and so well and giving them the best nurturing.
فعلتم ما طلبتم منكم.
You have fulfilled what I have asked you.
وأنفسكم وأهلكم نار.
Save yourselves and your families from fire.
فعلتم ما سألتكم.
You have done so. I'm not going to ask you about anything else.
أما أنكم تعكسوا القضية فسأحاسبكم.
But now, because you're flipping around this these priorities,
فسأحاسبكم.
You will be brought into account.
قلت لكم قوا أنفسكم وأهلكم نارا ماذا فعلتم.
I told you, save yourselves and your families from a fire, but what have you done?
أدخلتهم نارا.
You've entered them into the fire.
أرسلتهم إلى المدارس.
You sent them to those schools.
أرسلتهم إلى الكفار.
Forget I keep saying public schools, but private schools, whatever schools.
فعلتم ما فعلتم. أمانة في أيديكم.
They were a responsibility in your hands that you knew you were going to be asked about.
ماذا فعلتم؟
What did you do?
كلكم راعٍ وكلكم مسؤول عن رعيته. خلاص السؤال.
Each one of you is a shepherd, and you will be asked about your flock. Well, now you're being asked about your flock.
انتقلت إلى المقبرة.
You went to your cemetery.
تركت ابنك يحمل شهادة.
You left your child with what? A degree.
يصلي أو لا يصلي.
Is he praying or not praying? That's the question.
مطلقاً لا.
No, he doesn't pray at all.
هل قرأ فرض عيني؟ لا.
Did he study his فرض عين? What?
لا.
No.
لا يعلم اسم فرض العين.
He doesn't know what فرض عين is.
تعلم هذا. نويف قال لي دخل في مسجد أهله كاملي لا يعرفون فرض العين. اسم فرض العين.
This brother said he entered into a masjid. To a full masjid, a known established masjid, and no one there knew what fard ayn was. And then one of them said, "Oh, no, I know what fard ayn is. Fard means obligatory, and ayn is a letter in the alphabet, so it's the obligatory of ayn."
هذا مسجد بنية. قال لا معنى فرض العين, معنى العين, العين الغين. مسجد. أصحاب وأصحاب والمسجد أهله كل أبنائهم أحفادهم مملؤون من إيش من 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 إيش من ديفيس بوركلي ستانفورد أسان كلهم أفغان أنت تعرف وباكستان.
And the people in that masjid, all of them, them themselves may not, but their children and their grandchildren went to Berkeley and Davis and Stanford and so on.
ودفعوا ما دفعوا
And they spent what they spent to get them through school.
وسيدفعون ما يدفعون يوم القيامة.
But they will they will pay what they will pay in the day of judgment.
كلكم راعي وكلكم مسمع رايت. حتى أكون أنا ما أكون خائن.
Because the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم has told us this questioning is guaranteed.
حتى خلونا حتى نكون واقعيين.
So I need to tell you this. So I tell you about this reality. So that I'm not betraying you, that school is not something that is a priority for you.
ألقاه في اليم مكتوفا وقال له إياك إياك أن تبتل بالماء هذا مستحيل.
That he threw him. The example is like he threw him into the middle of the sea.
محيط ليس بحر.
The ocean, while his hands and feet were tied, and he told him, "Don't get wet."
ألقاه في المدرسة. الكفرية الانترنت الكمبيوتر قالوا انت يا ابني ابقى مسلم اسمك محمد.
He kicked him, tossed him into the world of the internet and computers and school, and he told him, oh, you're a Muslim, stay a Muslim.
انت اسمك محمد.
Your name is Muhammad.
اسمك احمد.
Here, I'm tossing you into the middle of
كفر and nonsense. انت اصلك من؟ من اي بلد؟
You need to understand who you are and where you're from. What country are you from?
انت ابو بكر الليبي.
You're Abu Bakr or you're a Libyan.
انت نويلي يعني افغاني.
This is what Islam is to people. Oh, this is your Wasim, your Moroccan.
هذا هو الذي سمعوا عن الإسلام. لا شيء. دولتك مسلمة. أنت جزائري.
This is what they heard.
إذا كان محظوظا Sunday school يوم الأحد يوم الكنيسة. Sunday school.
And if they're lucky, then maybe they went to Sunday school.
هذا صحيح ولا؟
نعم.
Sunday school أحسن منها جدا الكنيسة.
Really honestly, Sunday school often the churches are better to send your children.
من المدرس هنا؟ من المدرس هنا؟
Who's teaching in the Sunday school?
بولدا 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 بولدا.
I don't think I need to translate.
Stupid, 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 stupid. Learn from a stupid until when you open books, he's, you know, he's, I think he's in Abu Hassan Nadawi or someone said this. Someone said this. I believe this. I think this. Is somewhere, يعني I think my teacher said something. I had to open my notebook. I need. Is هذا هو الموجود هذا صحيح؟
جدا جدا 100% نعم.
Yes, okay, Sheikh, how are you doing? He's stupid. If you tell this man Sheikh, والله student is stupid.
حتى ليس الشيخ يعني الناس.
مولانا مولانا.
الناس العاديون يدرسون يعني ما.
مولانا مولانا مولانا. Yes, مولانا. He's stupid. Yeah, to tell him stupid.
هم نساء غير متحجبات.
نعم نعم. Listen, I like this. أنا أحب النساء غير متحجبات. في هذا المكان أحسن يكون واضح. I like this.
That in some cases, yes, it's the uneducated imams or supposed, even if they're
Muslim,
called sheikhs
99.
And so on, teaching, they don't even know how to recite the Quran themselves properly, just completely. Everything goes back to the translation and so on. That's the majority, that's the one case. But then even more than that is women. I said women who are not wearing hijabs and so on. They put on their hijab and go to teach the kids in the Sunday school. And they're reading from the book and they don't know what they're reading and they don't know what they're teaching. Whether it's about the prophets or teaching the Quran or whatever it is. But the response is that I love, you know, that women would come without hijab and teach in the masjid in that state.
So it's
very obvious. You know what the state of things is instead of the guy who is being called Mawlana and Sheikh and he's teaching the same quality of education.
شيطانة جدا أحسن عندي شيطانة جدا.
A female شيطان is better for me.
أحسن عندي جدا. لأن شيطان منافق وهاي شيطانة واضح.
Because a clear شيطان is better than a hypocrite شيطان.
لا تفيد عندي أنا لا تفيد عندي اللحيات.
These hollow beards and turbans mean nothing to me.
No, you're not work with me. No, no. A heater. A heat is what? هذا عمل المنافقين. أول واجب على من كلف تصحيح إيمانه ويعرف مصلحة فرض العين، يصلح ما يعرف ما يصلح به فرض عين، ما يصلح به فرض عين. So هذا أو من أول يوم بلغ تكليف.
So he says that again, the first obligation upon the responsible person is number one, to correct his faith, to learn the proper aqidah meaning, to memorize and study the proper aqidah, and number two, to learn the knowledge that is needed to correct one's fard ayn, such as
tahara, والصلاه والصيام والزكاه والحج.
Knowing and memorizing firmly the rulings of salah and purification and fasting and hajj and so on.
الزواج إن كان سيتزوج واجب عليه.
الزكاة. And if a person is going to get married, then the knowledge then the basics in regard to marriage become fard on him now.
بر الوالدين كان والدي أحياء.
If his parents are alive, then he needs to know بر الوالدين.
ما يقدم من النصائح لزوجته إن كان سيتزوج واجب.
If he's going to get married, he needs to know what his obligation towards his wife is, what he needs to teach her and advise her.
واجب هذا واجب فرض عين عليه ما مسؤولية عليه.
It becomes fard upon him now.
نعم بصلاح فرض العين كل احكام للطهر والصلاه والصيام وواجب حفظ حدود الحي واجب على الانسان ان يحفظ حدود الله تعالى.
He says and it is obligatory and he's going to start with this part first. He says and it is obligatory for him to hold the boundaries of Allah in his commands and prohibitions.
الا يقرب حدود الله تلك حدود
الله. He doesn't even come close to the boundaries of Allah.
كالراعي حول الحمى يوشك ان يقع فيه.
As the example the Prophet ﷺ visualized, he said, like a shepherd who is grazing his flock around the king's boundary. What's going to happen if your sheep are grazing 5 inches away from the king's land? What's the danger there? They're already in trouble. They're going to enter and go beyond the boundaries if you're playing near them.
ولا تقربوا الزنا.
That's why Allah سبحانه وتعالى doesn't say don't do الزنا.
لا تقربوا أسباب الزنا أصلا.
Don't come close to zina, meaning don't come close to the things that lead one to fornication, to intercourse before marriage or outside of marriage.
لأن الحدود خطيرة جدا.
Because those boundaries that Allah سبحانه وتعالى has set, those are very very dangerous.
أنتم الآن تعلمون أن مكسيك مخاطرون بأنفسهم؟ أتعلمون أن مكسيك مخاطرون بأنفسهم لدخول من حدود أمريكا بدون إذن؟
That you know what people from Mexico do to you know and the dangers they put themselves through to and the risks to try to cross the border into America.
وكلكم يعتقدونهم أغبياء.
And then you think that they're fools for doing so.
ولا تعتقدون أنفسكم أغبياء.
But you don't think that you are fools.
لا لا تعتقد أنفسكم أذكياء.
No, you think that you're so smart and you know.
Think smart and Mexicans stupid. No, Mexicans best than you. المكسيكيون أحسن منكم ذكاء. إنهم خاطروا فقط بشيء من الدنيا عالي.
No, the Mexicans they know those Mexicans they know better than you.
أحسن منكم أقل منكم بكثير.
Because what borders are they risking to come close towards and so on? Those are worldly borders and those are worldly risks. So that boldness that they need is only towards this world.
أو يتجاوزون حدود أمريكا وأما أنتم ترتبون لحدود رب العالمين رب أمريكا ورب الغرب ورب العجم ورب 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 ورب.
They're bold by coming towards the American borders, but you are bold and foolish to approach the borders of the Lord of the worlds and the Lord of America and the Lord of Mexico and the Lord of everywhere.
وترتبون أبناءكم لتجاوز تلك الحدود.
And you
تجهزونهم وتشجعونهم
encourage
وتساعدونهم
and provide and help the means for your children to transgress those borders and to not know them.
وزوجاتكم
and your wives.
تشجعونهم وتساعدونهم وتقودونهم لتجاوز حدود الله تعالى.
That you are assisting them, you're enabling them and helping them and facilitating for them the transgression of Allah's boundaries. And you're teaching them how to do so. Is this true or not? نعم هذا حياتنا.
Is حياتكم صحيح?
This is the life of the people, yeah.
Okay. الصيام فرض لنا كأحكام الطهر والصلاة والصيام وواجب حفظ حدود الحي بالوقف ما هو الحدود بالوقف عند أمره هذا هو ولا ذكر الله أكبر رجعوا إلى الدرس اليوم ولا ذكر الله أكبر بالوقف عند أمره والنهي
so then
رجعوا إلى الدرس اليوم
he says and it is obligatory to maintain the boundaries of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This was mentioned. But how do you maintain the boundaries of Allah? What does it mean? To hold those boundaries of Allah. It means to stop at Allah's commands and prohibitions. This is exactly what was being discussed this morning after Fajr, the previous lesson to this one, those boundaries of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is greater, meaning remembering Allah and obeying Him when it comes to His commands and prohibitions. This is obligatory.
Umar ibn Abdul Aziz said that
taqwa is not having plentiful fasting and charity. Or sitting in dhikr for a long time. No, that's not what taqwa means. Rather, in fact, taqwa is to stop at Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's commands and prohibitions. That Allah says, that's it. That's the end of the story. Allah said, that's it. That's the end of the discussion. I'm not going to do, I'm going to do. That's it. We hear and we obey. كان قول المؤمنين إذا دعوا إلى الله ورسوله يحكم بينهم أن يقولوا سمعنا وأطعنا. Indeed, the statement of the believers, once they are called to Allah and His Messenger to judge them, they will is to say, we hear and we obey.
لا يقول نحن نحتاج تأويل نحتاج نعرف لماذا.
They don't say we need to find some exception, we need to understand why we need to do this. We need to just explain to us why.
سمعنا وأطعنا.
We need to be convinced. No, we hear and we obey.
لأنهم إذا قالوا لماذا وإذا قالوا هذا ربما ليس الصحيح يقال لهم أم يخافون أن يحيف الله عليهم ورسوله.
If they know this is the command from Allah. If they know this is the command from Allah and yet their response is still to doubt the validity or that this is the best way or to hesitate or not accept, then it would be told to them the other verse, or do they, meaning the hypocrites, or do they fear that Allah and the Messenger would transgress against them, would oppress them? No, they are the ones who are the oppressors. Meaning that us as Muslims, we have no freedom of choice.
لا يوجد حرية في الإسلام أصلا.
There's no freedom of choice in Islam at all.
عندما يقول الله خلاص.
Once Allah says, that's it.
المسلم لا خيار له أصلا.
The Muslim has no freedom of choice.
أتعلمون ما هو معنى المسلم؟
Do you know what the Muslim means?
بينها لكم رب العالمين.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala clarifies to you.
أسلمت وجهي لله. سمعا وطاعة.
I have submitted myself for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
سمعا وطاعة.
In I hear and I obey.
That's it. هذا هو معنى المسلم.
This is a Muslim.
حتى يكون صادق مع الله سبحانه وجل جلاله. قال.
So he can be truthful in his covenant with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This
الآخر يقال له الفاسق من فسقة النواة التمرة معناها خرجت عن الحدود.
So the other one who is still is not a kafir but is disobedient, this person is called a fasiq. What does fasiq mean? To break out of something. Like an arrow breaks through a target, it touched it for a second, but that's as far as its connection was with it, and then it went right through it. Like when a seed is budding, and the thing comes out of the seed, it went outside of it. It's no longer inside of it, practically. Meaning that this person really, they're not in a state of Islam. They're not adorning themselves with the garments of piety. Meaning they've escaped those garments of piety. They're no longer in that actual state.
هذا هو. فأولئك أولئك هم الفاسقون ما زالوا يقال لهم مسلمين ولكن ليسوا مسلمين حقيقة.
So yes, they are still called Muslims, but in reality, they're not true Muslims.
طيب. وأن يتوب قبل سخط الله واجب على المسلم أن يتابع التوبة. يتابع التوبة هي الأول.
So now, saying that it is obligatory for a Muslim to keep those boundaries of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by stopping at his commands and prohibitions, which nobody does 100%, he mentions immediately afterwards, and to repent to Allah
توبة
before
توبة
Allah's
توبة.
Punishment overtakes him, Allah's wrath
قبل أن يغضب
him.
الله عليه
before Allah's wrath destroys him
بالشغال بالملاهي ما يلهي عن الله تعالى
while he is busy and due to him being busy with distractions from Allah
وشرطها الندم شرط التوبة الندم.
So now the first thing that he's teaching about itself, he says, and the conditions of it, meaning repentance, number one, is a remorse, a deep regret.
الندم. الندم ليس سهلا.
Regret is not easy.
ليس أنا I'm sorry.
ما هو أقل الندم المقبول للتوبة؟
يتندم يكره بجدا يعود إلى تلك المعصية. يكره
ما هي أقل
لا لا يكره كره شديدا يكره كره
what is the least level of a regret a person has is that a person genuinely would hate for them to return to that sin
يندم يحزن
that they actually regret doing it
ماذا
that they're sad over doing it they wish
ماذا
they
قال
didn't
لك
do it.
الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم الأمين
what did the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم
في حديث البخاري
in the hadith of Bukhari
انت فقدت الصلاة ما صليت العصر ماذا قال
for a person who just missed the عصر prayer
كأنما فقد نفس أهله وماله
that how will that person feel in reality once he sees the outcome of his deeds and he will feel that just that what he missed out because of that one عصر prayer he will feel as devastated as the person who
يشعر حزنا يشعر حزنا
His entire family he came he found his family was killed and his house was destroyed and his wealth is gone
طيب هل تفعلون هذا؟
This is the utter devastation of missing one prayer.
طيلة أعماركم بلغتم الثلاثين ما صليتم.
But you've reached 30 years old, you haven't prayed a proper prayer.
وأسوأ من ذلك تصلوا بدون أحكام.
Worse than that, you're praying and but you don't pray properly.
تلعبون بدين الله تعالى ما تبتم من هذه الصلاة.
Playing around with the deen of Allah سبحانه وتعالى.
لماذا لا تتوبوا من هذه الطهارة وهذه الصلاة؟
Why aren't you repenting from your invalid purification and prayer?
أنتم لا تعتقدون هذه معصية هذه مصيبة أخرى.
The problem is you don't think that you're doing a sin when you pray those invalid prayers and when you haven't learned how to do.
أنا ما سمعت أحد يقول هذه معصية. ما سمعت أحد يقول واحد يدخل المسجد بدون معرفة شروط هذا عاصي.
I haven't heard a single person. I haven't heard a single person saying that your presence in the masjid, O people who are not purifying themselves, is haram. Your prayer is haram. This is a sin that you are doing by being in the masjid and coming to the masjid. Have you heard this in your life? I've never heard this in my life. This is absolutely a matter of consensus.
كتاباً وسنةً وقرآناً.
The Quran and the
Sunnah. إجماع.
And the consensus of the scholars, this is absolutely forbidden.
ماذا يقول ربنا ولا جنوبا إلا عابر السبيل.
Allah سبحانه وتعالى says.
القرآن.
And not in a state of major ritual impurity, except.
عابر طريق ما عندك طريق لا بد أن
تأخذ. There's no way to pass by except.
يقتلك اللصوص أو الأسود. ما عندك طريق لا بد أن تمر سريع.
That if for that person to enter the masjid is forbidden, unless they are. Unless there's no way they have to run through that way, there's a danger for them if they don't pass through it.
أنتم تسكنون المساجد بالجنابة والحيض والنفاس.
But you fill the masjids while you are.
تسكنون ليس فيل تسكنون.
And you live in the masjids while you are in a state of major ritual impurity due to intercourse and menstruation and so on.
وبعد ذلك تصلون مع ذلك.
And then you're praying in that same state.
وتعتقدون أنكم صحابة.
And you think you're like the companions.
هذا صحيح أم لا؟
نعم.
أخبرنا عنكم.
نعم نعم جدا.
Let us know about all of your people.
نعم.
أخبرنا عنكم. أخبرنا عنكم. ترجم له.
Tell us about your people now.
طلابي كانوا في
لا لا أخبرنا عنكم أخبرنا
أنا أخبر ترجمت هو ما سمعوا قالوا ما سمعنا ما هو الغسل قلت لهم ما هو الغسل قالوا ماذا كان في درس القرآن
نعم
هذا طلابي أنا
thank you very much for you're a student thank you
my students were in my class and then one day and it occurred to me because the sheikh was saying this I said okay let me ask them so I said do you guys know what ghusl is they said what
هذا الرجل أفغاني وعندهم مسجد هذا الرجل أفغاني وعندهم مسجد كبير تبرع عليه بأكثر من مليونين دولار تقريبا هما ما يعرفون اسم فرض العين هذا الرجل هذا الشيخ
this man he went to the masjid that was built with like over $2 million and the people there don't know what fard ayn is
اسمه ليس اسم ما سمعوا
forget about ghusl they don't know what fard ayn is
اسم
the name of fard ayn they don't know
هل هل فرض العين معناها العين A B C هل هي معنى العين العين قال هل هي لا هذا الشيء انا اخطات قال هل هي معنى العين هذه
and then the other one yes the other one he said oh no no عين It's not just the letter عين also means the eye, the fard of the eye meaning. Oh no, I was wrong. It means the fard of the eye. The fard of the eye, yeah, that's a part of it to lower your gaze from haram.
I will tell you fard eye.
That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, tell the believing men, tell the believing women to lower their gaze and guard their private parts. The opposite of what you're doing.
أن يتوب قبل سخط الله سبحانه عليه بالملائكة الصلاة بدون طهارة وصيام شرطها الندم والنية أن يكف ينوي أن يكف عن المعصية التي هو فيها الآن.
So to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala before Allah's wrath overtakes you due to and while being involved in those distractions from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala such as praying without knowledge. And then he says, and the conditions of it are that deep regret, that remorse, and the intention to never return to that sin. The intention to never return to that sin for as long as they live. So that means people's repentance in Ramadan in modern times, this is not a true repentance. It is actually them persisting upon their sin. The type of Ramadan repentance meaning that the we do, that we say we will stop doing it for Ramadan and we'll return to it after. That's not a repentance. This is an intention to do the sin later. That means that repentance in itself is sin. Meaning that even our repentance is a sin, unfortunately. So the intention to never return to it and to stop doing the sin is the third condition of repentance. But this is an intention to return to it. And then he says, and not to delay, and one cannot delay their repentance. Intentions of delaying repentance. What does delaying repentance, for example, saying, I'm going to repent later, or even, inshallah, when the Ramadan starts, I'm going to start praying my prayers. To feel bad before Ramadan and say when Ramadan comes, you'll see.
Until Ramadan.
Just wait until Ramadan comes, I'll be praying all five prayers. That's a sin. But this is your repentance. Or to say, just, you know, I'll do it when Allah guides me, you know, when Allah,
I'm
not there yet, but inshallah, when Allah guides me, I'm just waiting for Allah's guidance to come, but I'm not really there yet right now. Forget about this being repentance or acceptable repentance. He said, this is actually one of the descriptions of the people of hellfire and the people who die upon sinfulness without ever changing. That is their statement their whole life, was that
I'll change later, I'll repent later, or when Allah guides me. And this is also a sign of what? Of the heart being blinded from Iman. And he says, and it is, meaning it is obligatory to guard the tongue from outright sinfulness, shamelessness. Meaning just talking about things that a person, you know, it's inappropriate to talk about. Talking about, you know, private parts, talking about intercourse, etc. Mentioning these words that are, you know, are shameful to be mentioned publicly. This isn't from every ugly word, and it is also forbidden for a person. Now he begins with the tongue. What is haram for a person to say immediately after repentance? And he says, you know, and not only those shameful words, but any ugly words, and the swearing by divorce is also forbidden. Why is it, and it is haram for him to swear by divorce? Meaning, I swear if you do that, I'll divorce you, or I swear I divorce my wife if this and this happens. And to belittle a Muslim, insult them, to insult them, or to you know, abuse them using a, or insult them, meaning by a deficiency that they do have. That all of these things are forbidden, except unless a person has a Islamic right to do so, like if they're a judge or the Amir al-Mu'mineen and so on. Or the father with his children in the right time and so on. Or the husband with his wife in some cases.
والحفظ للبصر عن حرام كنظرة تؤذي أخ الإسلام.
And he said, then he goes from the tongue to the eyes. He says, and to guard the gaze from what is forbidden, such as looking at a Muslim person in a way that is belittling them.
ينظر إليه نظرة غير محترمة.
Or looking at them in a way that's disrespectful.
في حديث مسلم بحسب امرئ من الشر أن يحقر أخاه المسلم.
It is mentioned in Hadith in Muslim that it is sufficient evil for a person, if they do no other evil, it is sufficient evil in itself for a person to belittle their Muslim brother.
And
once they're a sinful person, a sinner,
who,
there's no benefit of interacting with them, that they will never stop their sin, then it becomes obligatory, without abusing them, without insulting them, you don't need to attack them, but to stay away from them. Stay, keep your distance. Distance yourself from them. Don't come close to them.
إذا رأيته بطريق خذ طريق أخرى.
Right, there's if they're a person who there's no hope, they don't want to become better, they have no desire to be better, they are not going to become better, then you see them taking one way, you take the other way.
المرء على دين خليله أمر أحد.
Because a person is on the way of their closest friends, so one should be very careful who they befriend.
بالعكس نحن نقول ما شاء الله أي مسهم أنا أشتاق له هو يضحكني ويفعل.
But we say actually no, you know, this is one of my old friends, you know, he's so funny, you know, let's go, we have to catch up.
I miss him. أنا أشتاق إليه. أشتاق إليه. ماذا تشتاق إليه؟
Why do you miss him?
هذا عدو لله.
This is an enemy of Allah and His Messenger.
وسترى عداوته يوم القيامة.
And you'll see him turn against you on the Day of Judgment.
الأخلاء يومئذ بعضهم لبعض عدو إلا المتقين.
Allah سبحانه وتعالى says the closest friends on that
يوم
day
القيامة عدو
are enemies to one another except for the muttaqin.
أعلموا أنكم أصدقاءكم يا إخواتي ويا إخواني أصدقاءكم في الدنيا على غير الله تعالى سيكون أعداءكم يوم القيامة.
No, oh my sisters, oh my brothers. No.
ولو إخوانكم أشقاءكم.
That your close friends, your buddies, the people who you're hanging out with.
ولو إخوتكم من أب وأم.
Even if they're your siblings from your father and your mother. On the day of judgment, they will turn against you entirely, be your complete enemies and witnesses against you and turning against you. And they will witness, they will be ratting you out with the details of what you did in front of them. Know that they're going to show their animosity, their real animosity on the day of judgment, they will turn against you. Don't be deceived.
I wish be like with my sister, my brother, who لا يصلي, لا يتطهر. This is still my brother.
Is not purifying themselves and so on, not praying.
لا تخدعوا أنفسكم.
Don't deceive yourselves.
هذه ما زالت أختي. لا طيب ساعده.
Oh, she's my sister. She's this and that.
هذا أخي طيب.
Yes, help them, encourage them, guide them.
أعطي شيء ولكن ابتعد منه.
Give them something, but don't share in their company if there's no benefit.
لا تشتاق إليه.
Don't miss them.
لا تشتاق إليه. ساعده ادعوه إلى الله تعالى إن قدرت وإلا فاحفظ نفسك.
Call them to Allah سبحانه وتعالى if you're able to do so properly. Otherwise, save yourself.
ابتعد منهم.
Distance yourself from them. Save yourself. You're the priority.
ابتعد منهم. لأن الله سبحانه وجل وعلا يقول لا تجد قوما يؤمنون بالله واليوم الآخر يوادون من حاد الله ورسوله ولو كانوا آباءهم أو أبناءهم أو إخوانهم أو عشيرتهم.
Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala explains this, that Allah says you will not see a people who believe in Allah and the last day who are loving, showing love and affection towards whom?
Those
who are opposing Allah and the Messenger. Even if they are their parents or their children
or from their tribe, or
their siblings, whatever it may be.
Tell them, you
know, you're my mother. You're my mother. You have the greatest right over me. You have the greatest right over me, and I will serve you. I'll provide for you whatever you want. I'll give you whatever you need. But anything that's going to take me away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala,
no.
If you start talking about, you know, Afghan culture or Arab culture or whatever culture,
leave me
out of those things that are forbidden.
I had to go. I have to go. تحتاج أن تذهب. ما هو العرف؟ قلنا العرف غير المحرمات. أخبرونا عن العرف.
Tell me about what people are doing, cultural events and so on that is not forbidden.
فقط حضور الولائم, حضور الغيبة, حضور النميمة.
Just gossiping and backbiting and haram weddings and gatherings.
المطعم تأكلون هناك كلكم يرى مرأة كاشفة شاب يدخن.
Restaurants, the least harmful thing you're seeing is women who are not wearing hijabs and young men who are smoking and on their dates and whatnot.
His girlfriend has a boyfriend. That's it. طيب انتم اهلي ولكن ماذا نفعل؟ انا ما اريد ان اكون معي لا اريد ان اكون عندي حرب مع الله. طيب انتم اهلي طيب.
Yes, of course you are my family, but I don't want to wage war against Allah سبحانه وتعالى.
انا الله ورسوله حق يرضوه. انا الله تعالى قال لي ذلك خلاص.
Actually for me, Allah and His Messenger are more befitting to please.
خلاص. وحفظهما استعلى فواجب دون أذن أن يهجر يترك.
That if there is a person who is a sinner who is not going to learn, who is not going to change and be and they don't want to leave their sin, then it is becomes obligatory without bothering them, without hurting them, to distance yourself from them, to abandon them.
هو نظر حركاته ونظر معصيته حرام.
to abandon them. Why even looking at their false worship, their worship that is improper, that's a sin. To look at somebody doing a sin is haram.
نعم.
So to look at them moving, to look at them doing their haram and doing their worship, both are haram.
وكل فعل أو كلام من الحوار يجب كف السمع عنه والبصر نص محارم اللسان.
And every statement or action that is forbidden, to look at somebody, to observe somebody doing it, is also forbidden.
أنا كل فعل وكلام ترى ما ترى أخوك يمارس محرمات جاء مع صديقته ومع جاءت مع صديقته جاءت كاشف مع تحجب لا تنظر إلى هذا الفعل حرام هذا حرام نعم.
When a person is doing haram, they're going with their boyfriend or girlfriend. They're not wearing their hijab, etc., etc., to look at them doing this sin is haram.
يفعلون الحرام فنظرهم حرام. هذا كلام العلماء لا بد أن تفهموا هذا دعونا من العرف والمشاكل.
Forget about culture. This is unheard of.
أنا أقول لكم تعبدون الله بالعرف. أنتم تعبدون الله بالعرف.
This is unheard of, but this is what the scholars have mentioned.
أنتم تعبدون الله بالعرف.
But you don't worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by the way of the Muslims and the scholars. You worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala based on culture.
العرف مخت هذا واللي قلت لكم أنكم تطبقون العرف أكثر من الفاتحة بكثير جدا.
I've told you you apply culture more than the فاتحة itself by far.
لأنكم تلحنون في الفاتحة وتحسنون العرف بشكل عجيب جدا. لا تصححون التجويد في الفاتحة ولكن العرف ما شاء الله.
You'll never even dream of reciting the فاتحة properly or even think about its proper recitation. But culture, you have to be to the T exactly doing everything right.
حتى لا هذا صحيح أبدا.
نعم.
Correct or not? العرف من أخطأ فيه فقد أخطأ في أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. هذا صحيح.
That it's so severe when somebody does a cultural, they mess up something cultural, as if they've messed up their أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله.
بل أسوأ.
Actually, it's worse.
هذا صحيح أم لا؟
تعرف أنه أسوأ.
نعم صحيح. Yes, you're right. You're worse.
ما عندهم لا يعرفون
كثير. لا ولكن لو أخطأت في شيء من العقيدة وكبريات هذا عادي.
نعم هذا عادي. فإن أخطأ في العرف
أنا أعرف كم من مرأة طلقت بماذا؟ خالفت العرف.
I know how many women who are divorced for what? Because they went against culture.
فقط ما هيأت طعام أو شيء على عرف القوم اللي هو منها.
That she didn't prepare, the food and the so
exactly.
on. The relatives came over and she didn't get the cultural food ready. She got divorced.
هذا صحيح أم لا؟
نعم.
هذا صحيح. Thank you very much. Thank you أيها المسلمون. شكرا لكم أيها المسلمون. مرأة طلقت بسبب أنها ما حضرت الطعام المناسب لقومه وضيوفه ولكن تركت الصلاة وخرجت هذا عادي.
It's such a big deal for
شكرا
somebody,
لك يا رجل.
For a woman not to get the cultural food ready.
بالضبط يعني بالضبط.
Exactly right. بالضبط. For the guests and the relatives who come over, that she'll be divorced.
هذا عادي.
But people, this is.
هذا عادي ممدوح. هذا الرجل ممدوح هذا شجاع.
This man is considered bold and brave. That wow, he divorced his wife who was not a fit wife.
I like this man.
And instead, subhanAllah, people they're not knowing their basic aqidah and their la ilaha illallah even.
هي تخرج وتأتي ما عندها مشكلة. No problem. She going out, no problem.
And that same woman can go and do whatever haram she wants to go and leave the house without hijab and whatever.
لا مشكلة.
No problem.
لا تصلي أصلا.
She doesn't even pray. Okay,
لا مشكلة. ما دمتي تصنع الحلويات الأفغانية والعربية وتطبخ هذا أهم شيء.
As long as you're making
وتطبخ طبخة مناسبة هذا كافي.
Afghan sweets and those dishes, then.
ما دمتي تطبقي قومي. أنت ديسي عربي كافي خلاص.
So long as you're fulfilling my cultural requirements, whether Desi or Arab or whatever, then you're fine.
لذلك تعرف إنه عندما يأتي الزواج ماذا تعرفين من الطبخ؟ هل تعرفين الطبخ الفلاني؟
That's why when people get married, do you know how to cook this and this food?
هذا صحيح؟
نعم.
طيب.
يتعلمون بعد الزواج ولكن.
نعم.
لابد.
لكن الطهارة والصلاة للرجل بس هذا ما
Yeah, they may have to learn after marriage, but as far as purification and prayer, they never even heard of
it. He's stupid. He's a very stupid man. I hate this man. If anyone won't accept this man, I believe this woman very stupid. I believe 100% plus 10, this woman very stupid. I hate this woman, this man, both. I hate his family. I hate his family. لله تعالى لله سبحانه جل جلاله أن يحب المرأة لا يحبه إلا لله ويبغض المرأة لا يبغضه إلا لله من علامة الإيمان أن يحب المرأة لا يحبه إلا لله ويبغض لله اشهدوا جميعا أني أكره إلى جماعة أكره هذه الجماعة لله سبحانه وتعالى.
It is from the signs of Iman to love others for the sake of Allah and to hate for the sake of Allah.
I hate this people for sake of Allah. I hate this man and this woman, both. I hate them. I hate their kids. I hate their family. I hate them. أنا أكرههم جدا. أكرههم جدا. أكرههم. I hate. إنني من المسلمين. 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 لا إله إلا الله. لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله المسلمون ارتحلتم ما بقي لكم إلا اسم الإسلام ارتحلتم رحلتم من زمان.
So even looking at these basic requirements, we see that the Muslims have been gone away from Islam a long time ago, that the only thing remains is the name.
مرأة كم تجد من ضرب وشتم أنها خالفت عرفها.
Women, they will be abused and insulted for contradicting their culture.
ولا تجد كلمة صعبة من زوجها لو خالفت شرع الله كله من أوله إلى آخره.
You don't see a harsh word from her husband.
ولا تغير وجه.
Or even his state or his face will not change if she goes against the command of Allah in everything in every matter.
ولا يمكن هو أن يحلم بذلك في نومه.
And he cannot dream of doing that even in his sleep.
ولو قال لها ذلك لغاضبت قالت أنت من أنت من أنت.
And if he tells her, then she'll say, how can you judge me?
لماذا? He judge you only for culture. وفقط يحكم عليك.
He can only judge you for culture.
Yes, because I'm stupid. I accept you because I'm stupid. هذا صحيح. هذا I hate this life. Why I tell you I hate this life? أنا قلت لكم مليار مرة. أنا أكره هذه الحياة. أنا أكره هذه الحياة. هذه حياة الوحوش والبقر والغنم والطيور والحشرات ليست حياة بني آدم.
Right, this is the life of insects and cows. It's not the life of human beings.
خصوصا المسلمين هذه حياتهم بعيدة من هذا. هذه يرضى العاقل بهذا.
How can a sane
أنا عاقل نرضى بهذا البليد.
Person be content with this lifestyle.
أنا نرضى بأن يتزوجني ثورة وبقرة. ترجم.
Then how could I be pleased with marrying a bull or a cow?
وحفظ ما استطاع للجوارح يجب على المسلم أن يحفظ جوارحه كلها والجوارح التي تطيع الله تعالى أو تعصيه هي جوارح سبعة بقدر عدد أبواب جهنم.
And he says, and then after he mentions the tongue and the eyes, of course, the tongue is very critical. It's crucial to protect the tongue. And then he mentions the eyes. Now he says, and it is obligatory for him to protect all the limbs. So now he's mentioning the other five limbs, meaning the total of seven limbs, as many as the doors, the gates of hellfire.
سبع كأبواب الجحيم في العدد فرع جميعها وألزمها السدد.
So he it is mentioned that there are seven. It's not a coincidence that there are seven gates of hellfire, just like there are those seven limbs you will be questioned about. So
زرعها جميعها راع انت مسؤول عنها
كلكم
راعي راعي ارعاها
that is a part of your responsibility you have to
ارعاها الجوارح السبعه
tend to them to keep them away from haram
احذر بقدمك ان تذهب به الى حرام خطير
beware of taking your feet one step towards the haram
يدك ان تفعل بها حرام
or to do any haram with your hands
عينك ان تفعل بها حرام
to do any haram with your eyes
لسانك ان تفعل بها حرام
Or with your tongue.
فرجك أن تفعل به حرام.
Or with your private parts.
بطنك أن تأكل به حرام.
Your stomach to eat haram.
أما القلب هو الأصل.
But the heart itself, that is the root.
وأصلها القلب. أصلها الأمير القلب كامل.
The root of all of this is the heart.
لذلك إذا صلح القلب تجد البدن كله صالح.
The foundation is the
heart. إذا صلح القلب. تجد اليد مطيعة والعين مطيعة والرجل مطيعة والفرج مطيع وكل شيء.
So if that foundation, the heart, is corrected, then everything else will be corrected and obedient. The hands, the tongue, the feet, everything will be corrected.
كل ما قال الله توقف لأن القلب صالحة.
Because the heart is set in its foundation of connection to Allah, then it will stop.
كل ما تسمعناه خلاص. استغفر الله. أنا I'm here. كل ما تسمع نهي أو أمر تقول لا خلاص ما في خيار هذه الجوارح عند أمير يقول افعلي أو لا تفعلي خلاص
that these limbs have a commander that is telling them do or don't do and that commander it's settled in its connection to Allah سبحانه وتعالى so that's it
لذلك القلب عندما يصبح خلاص لا تجد الآن الفساد كله من فساد القلب لا إن في الفساد مضغة إذا صلحت صلح الجسد كله وإذا فسدت فسد الجسد كله ولا وهي القلب وكل من له أي مخالفة للشريعة لا أصل فيها القلب
and so the opposite also works anything that is in contradiction to the sharia any corruption will be if there's in the heart then that will manifest in all the limbs and the other way around as well And this is as the Prophet ﷺ said in the hadith of Bukhari and Muslim that indeed in the heart is a morsel of flesh. If it is corrected, then the rest of the body is corrected.
Alhamdulillah.
And if it is corrupted, then the rest of the body is corrupted. Indeed, it is the heart.
لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله يا أيها المسلمون أنتم لا تقدرون على حر النهار
Oh Muslims, you can't even handle the heat of the sun at daytime.
بل غالبكم في أمريكا لا يقدر على حر البيت.
You can't even handle, most of you in America can't even handle the heat of
كلكم
your house.
يتنفس تنفس البرحاء.
Each one of you is panting in your own house if the AC is not on.
لا تقدرون على هذا.
You can't even handle that heat.
لا تقدرون على هذا. وقالوا لا تنفروا في الحر قل نار جهنم أشد حرا لو كان.
And they said, "Oh, don't go out in the heat." The hypocrites said, "Allah says, say the fire of hell is hotter if they only understood."
لا تعصوا الله نار جهنم أشد حرا لو كنت
Don't disobey Allah, the fire of hell is hotter.
خائفون من حرارة البيت.
You're afraid of the heat of the house.
أبناؤكم تخافون عليهم من ذلك.
You're worried about your children if the house is not cooled down.
من الجوع والعطش.
You're worried about your children from food, from hunger and thirst.
أما النار فلا يذوقون فيها بردا ولا شرابا.
But in the hellfire, people do not have any relief from the heat, nor any food or drink.
لا بردا ولا شرابا مطلقا.
No drink, no relief from the heat.
لا برودة أصلا.
No coldness, no coolness,
مطلقا.
No breeze.
لا طعاما مطلقا.
No food, no drink.
إلا حميما وغساقا. ماء حار يشوي الوجوه بأس الشر.
Except boiling water and pus.
إذا قرب من الوجه يشوي. يمزقه
so hot that it melts the face.
هذا هو الشراب لا بد أن تشربه كره ما في خيار.
This is the food that people in hellfire will
you
be
have
forced to
forced ما في خيار.
To consume.
يشوي الوجوه بئس الشراب.
That it roasts the faces. What a terrible drink it is.
وما هو الطعام؟
And what is the food of hellfire?
غساقا عصارة دماء الكافرين.
The pus of the disbelievers.
هذا هو الطعام والشراب. تخافون على أبنائكم من هذا وتجهزونهم لذلك. هنا تخافون عليهم من الجوع والعطش.
So here you're وتجهزون
أبنائكم لذلك.
You're claiming to love your children and care about them, so you're preventing them from the heat and from hunger and thirst.
لتجهزوهم لذلك.
But you're preparing them in every way to cast them into that eternal heat and
ليل
وأنها
أنا عندما أقول لكم أمي رمتني في دزر تقولها هاكني شو ما أمني أنا.
Whenever I tell you that my mother abandoned me in the desert.
رمتني أنا أقول رمتني.
She threw me in the desert.
هذه سناد قدومة.
You'll say, oh, how could she do that?
كيف أمك تجعلك في الصحراء ما عندك طعام ولا شراب وأنت يتيم.
That you didn't have food or drink in the desert, she didn't leave you with anything, and you're an orphan.
هذه ليست حنونة هاي الأم ليست حنونة.
This is not a
ما عندها أي رحمة.
This is not a merciful or a loving mother.
لكن أنتم أمهاتكم عندهم رحمة كاملة.
But you, your mothers, mashallah, had complete mercy.
MashaAllah, تأخذك إلى المدرسة وتجعلك
أيسي. She took you to school.
وتوقظك على الطعام والشراب يعني.
And she woke you up for breakfast and so on.
وتقول لك آسفة آسفة.
And she always tells you sorry.
طيب جزاكم الله خير. أنا بعيدة أمي عندي من أمهاتكم.
My mother is so different from your mothers.
أنا الحمد لله على أمي جزا الله خير. I love what my mom did. أنا أحب ما فعلت لي أمي. رمتني في الصحراء في مدرسة ما فيها طعام وشراب نعطش حتى الظهر ويأتينا الماء فأقول جزاك الله خيرا. اللهم برد عليها قبرها واجعله روضة من رياض الجنة وأعطها ما فعلت يا رب.
She threw me in the desert.
ننتظر الماء حتى ظهرا.
That we would wait until ظهر for the water to even come. To would be thirsty until ظهر.
وأقول
جزاء
الله.
Forget about any food or drink in the morning.
أما طعام وشراب هذا شيء آخر.
Forget about food and drink. Water would only be there at noon.
ولا جزاك الله خيرا شكرا.
And I would tell her جزاك الله.
اللهم املأ قبرها نورا ورياضا من
الله. والله fill her grave with light and make it a garden of the gardens
لأن
of
paradise. هذه هي التربية. هذه هي التربية.
Because that is the real upbringing.
وكانت تقول لنا لماذا لا أخاف عليكم النار كما أخاف عليكم الجوع والعطش.
And she would say, how could I not be afraid of the fire for you as I fear hunger and thirst for you.
لأن الله تعالى قوم أنفسكم وليكم نارا ما قال قوم أنفسكم لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله ليس اليتيم الذي قد مات والده إن اليتيم يتيم العلم والأدب.
Because that is what Allah سبحانه وتعالى says to save yourselves and your families from a fire. And it is mentioned that the orphan, the true orphan, is not the one who his parents passed away or his father passed away. It is the one who has no one to nurture them, to teach them how to be, teach them knowledge and teach them how to have good character.
هذا هو اليتيم.
That is the true.
قد يكون آباؤه وأجداده موجودين ولكن هو يتيم مسكين.
But a person could be sitting in the presence of their father and their grandfather, but they're still an orphan.
عمله سيء جدا عندما يخرج كبوحقتين يتيم ما قيل له شيء أصلا.
That once he leaves his house, as if nobody taught him anything.
لا ما ولا شيء ولا أصل مسكين يعني.
No foundation, no nothing.
أنا نعرف كم من الشباب بلغوا 18-20 سنة ما قال لهم آباءهم صلوا.
How many youth are like this that even when they reached 20 years old and they left the house and their parents never told them once to pray.
ما سمعوهم يقولوا صلوا.
They never heard their parents once saying go
أما
pray.
أما علموهم هذا شيء مستحيل.
As for teaching them, that's far from the reality.
مطلقاً. لكنهم حضروهم للمدارس ورتبوا لهم وقالوا لهم عليكم بعدم التقصير إن قصرتم فنحن لسنا أباكم.
They would never mention any of that to them, but if they tell them, you know, don't come home if you didn't do your homework or you didn't do well on your, you were not your parents if you don't do good at school.
لسنا أباكم. أحسن الدراسة وإلا.
You better not come home if you didn't do well in school.
الخارج عليك بالخارج. لا نتحمل مسؤوليتك
أصلاً. We have nothing to do with you if you don't do well.
عليك أنت ألا تترك نوعاً من الفساد حتى نكون أباك.
You have to do every kind of corruption so that we can be your parents.
جزاكم الله خير. هذا صحيح أم لا؟
نعم.
You're right. I'm right or not?
نعم.
Thank you.
Yes.
شكراً لكم. Thank you very much for Muslims. شكراً للمسلمين على فسادهم في الأرض. شكرا لكم على فسادكم.
Thank you very much for the corruption that you make.
شكرا لكم أيها المسلمون لفسادكم في الأرض. شكرا لكم. For to share فساد in the world, share corruption in the world. Thank you. هذا ما لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله. لا إله إلا الله. لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول 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 الله. توبوا إلى الله جميعا أيها المؤمنون لعلكم تفلحون. توبوا إلى الله جميعا أيها المؤمنون لعلكم تفلحون. توبوا إلى الله جميعا أيها المؤمنون لعلكم تفلحون.
Allah says, and repent to Allah, all of you, O believers, so that you may become successful. Repent from these lives that you have lived so that you can become successful now. That you thought that, oh, we were doing right and we were doing good. Repent from that way so that you will become successful now.
كنت لا تدري ولم تكن بالذي يسائل من يدري فكيف إذا تدري ومن أعجب الأشياء أنك لا تدري وأنك لا تدري بأنك لا تدري.
And if you do not know and you do not seek the one who knows, then you, how would you ever know? And from the strangest things is that you do not know and you do not even know that you don't know. That you have been murdered and you have no idea you have been murdered. This is called double murder. A person who is murdered who doesn't know that they're murdered.
Subhanallah, maqtul la ya'lamu annahu maqtul. Subhanallah, ajeeb. Like woman America, she think free, but he is مقتولة مسكين. Woman America, she think I free. He is مقتولة مسكين. أنا حرة. He is مقتولة مسكين. حتى شو زوجة يريد منها 50-50. مسكين. مسكين. I'm sorry for this woman. جزاكم الله خيرا كثيرا دعاء. أرجو لكم التوفيق والعافية. أرجو لكم التوفيق والعافية. أرجو الله لكم التوفيق والعافية. نرجو الله أنكم التوفيق والعافية وأن نستفيد من حياتنا باقيها.
آمين.
اللهم افدنا من باقي حياتنا.
آمين.
اللهم افدنا من باقي حياتنا.
آمين.
اللهم اجعلنا من الذين يستمعون القول فيتبعون أحسنه. قل لهم ذلك.
May Allah make us from those who hear the words and follow the best of them and grant us the ability to benefit from that which we have remaining of our lives.
اللهم اجعلنا من الذين يستمعون القول فيتبعون.
O Allah, make us from those who hear the words and follow the best of them.
اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه. وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه.
O Allah, show us the truth as truth and bless us with following it. And show us the evil as evil and falsehood as falsehood. And bless us with abstaining from it.
بعد أن يرى الإنسان الحق عيب عليه أن يبقى على.
After a person sees the truth, it is shameful for him to remain on evil.
عيب للمسلم أن يترك الحق واضحا. عيب. عيب.
It is a shame.
عيب على المسلم أن يرى الحق حقا ويتركه.
It is a shame for a Muslim to see the truth as truth and then to abandon it.
عيب. على من مضت عليه 30 سنة واربعون سنة وما زال يرى الباطل باطل ويتبعه هذا عيب.
It's a shame for the 30-40-year-old who has been doing wrong for so long and then realizes it and continues upon it.
عيب. عيب عليه.
It's a shame.
شاب الرأس 40 مضت ما زال.
His hair, it has white hairs. 40 years old.
هذا عيب 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 العمر مضى مضى يعني انت خلاص خلاص العمر مضى العمر مضى يا اخي.
That said your life has passed by.
العمر مضى مضى مضى.
What more do you want?
لا 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 مضى مضى مضى. يا خسارة نفس في تجارتها لم تشتري الدين بالدنيا ولم تسمي.
What a great loss in this exchange for an individual who sold out their deen for the dunya and got nothing in return.
من هو مثلي ما زال هذا خطير جدا. واحد مثلي في العمر ما زال هذا خطير.
Someone who is like me in age and who still hasn't woken up.
تجاوز الأربعين تجاوز.
You're beyond 40 years old. You have not woken up.
كما يقول في الأمريكان too late يعني هذا متأخر جدا. استغفر الله. واحد مثلي مازال هذا خطير مازال مازال مازال. أما أنت واستقبالك اللوى والصبا وقد أدبرت عشرون من بعد يا عشر تنحى عن الدنيا وداعي غرورها فمن سره مسلوب زخر يا غر. واحد تجاوز الأربعين ما زال يعتقد أن الدنيا مستقبلة هذا غبي جدا.
A person who is beyond 40 years old who the world has already passed them by and still is looking forward to the world coming towards them when it's actually turned away from them. They're still chasing it and it's unreachable now.
This is a great fool. يا أخي أنت عمرت عمرت خلاص أنت.
That you were given your age, you were given these years.
عقل يعني إذا أنت لم تعقل أنا لا أمل فيك خلاص.
If you do not wake up right now, there's no hope for you.
مضت 40 سنة وأنت لا تعقل.
40 years have passed by, you still haven't woken up.
بعيد الوقت الوقت متأخر متأخر متأخر. Too late. لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله. من أعجب الأشياء الناس قالوا إنهم لما يبلغوا 40 سنة يقولون هذه سن الشباب يقول يرجع إلى السن المتوسط صحيح؟
Then that now when people are 40 years old they think that they're youthful, they're even called middle aged.
Middle it's middle 40
40 is middle of what?
You stupid age. I will tell you all of you are 40 years like me or 50. You stupid age. You stupid age. If you believe you have, you want to go back to dinner, you stupid age. You stupid age. I tell you. Trust me. احترم 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 حياتي هذا خطير جدا. احترم الرأي الحقيقي هذا اي استوبيد. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك اشهد ان لا اله الا انت استغفرك واتوب اليك. ان شاء الله نتوقف ان شاء الله بعدين ان شاء الله بعد او نصف ساعه شيء صحيح؟ ان
شاء الله in about 30 minutes we'll return.
اعطونا الشراب وافتحوا